With Godot 4 being released recently, and it being the biggest release so far, I decided to compare the two versions by making the same game in Godot 3 and Godot 4. I'll be going over what I liked, disliked, and my overall opinions on the new version of Godot. Hope you enjoy. I got started with the basics. First, I needed to make a player character. For this game, I wanted to use Kenny's 1-bit pack. I decided to go with this little guy, I think he looks cool. After this, I quickly set up the movement for the player. With the movement done, the last thing I wanted to do was add a walking animation, which basically consists of a rotation property that rotates the sprite when they move. Looking good, but I think there's something missing. There, now we have a gun, but this looks a bit weird. I changed the sprite and added a bit of code that flips the player depending on the mouse position. Now, it was time to add some enemies. All I did was copy what I did for the player, except I used this bat sprite instead. When I had the enemy set up, I got to work adding detection to our enemy, player, and bullet so that they collide with one another. I then added some health variables so that our player and enemy can die. Then, with this done, I started coding the enemy movement. Basically, I set up a global player variable and connected it to our player script. Then, when the player is detected, I set the enemy position equal to that of the player. Great. Now we have an enemy that can move toward our player. With the basic gameplay elements done, I started working on the background. At first, I wanted to add procedural generation that infinitely loaded a background, but I realized that required effort and commitment. Instead, I created a small map using the Kenny tile map, then copy and pasted this so that the player had a larger arena. Then, I added a bit of detail to break up the monotony and make the background more interesting. Nice, now we have a simple background. With our background made, it was time to add enemy spawning. I added some code that will spawn an enemy in between two random points on the X and Y axis. I didn't really include anything to prevent an enemy from spawning in the game window, but that's a problem for another time. Next, I went ahead and added a simple score system, which had absolutely no flaws whatsoever. Alright, just kidding. I was able to fix this by separating the UI and adding it to our camera, then turning smoothening off. I then added some code that set the camera relative to the player, then had it follow the player's position. Now the UI sits on the screen without rotating, but it's just not the same without smoothening. Next, I went ahead and added a couple new enemies to the game. I also refined the enemy code so that it spawned the different enemies randomly. Now we have a lot more variety in our enemies. With the game practically done, it was time to start polishing. The first thing I did was change the player's gun from a pistol to an automatic SMG. After this, it was time to add some game juice. Hit animations, screen shake, you get the idea. Oh yeah, I added a menu too. Although there's definitely a bit more work that could be done, I think we have a pretty good prototype. With the base of the game done, it was time to move on to Godot 4. One of the first things I noticed was how clean the interface looks. Although it's just a simple color change, I think it looks nice. Anyway, I quickly got started making the player, which was practically identical to the former version of Godot, save for a few changes in the node names. I think that the UI has received many improvements, with a lot of things being in more accessible positions. It also offers a few more options that we didn't have in Godot 3. Overall, this version of Godot offers many quality of life features that simplify creation and make things a lot more efficient. With the player set up, it was time to start coding. This is the part I was most afraid of, since it was getting a bit of a rework. The first thing I noticed is a feature that automatically generates code for your scripts, which I have a feeling will save me and others a lot of time. This is probably one of my favorite changes. Anyway, after copying and manually writing the movement code, it didn't work. I was about to give up, when I came across this message. It explained the differences in the movement systems between both versions, which I didn't bother to read. Something something move and slide got removed. This is actually a change that I like, since now we don't have to define a velocity variable, and can use the one already in our program. We also don't need to worry about passing in variables to the move and slide function. After setting up a few other things for the game, I started adding the background. Tile maps are one of the things I heard of the most when looking into the Godot 4 update, so I was definitely interested to see how much of a difference was made. Suffice to say, in the beginning, I had absolutely no idea what I was doing. However, after watching a few tutorials, I was able to start creating my background. This was just as rushed and unfinished as last time. Tile maps are one of many things that got a major upgrade in Godot 4. Layering, for example, is a big improvement. Other notable features are the more fleshed out collision and physics system in the tilemap editor, as well as a little thing called scattering. This allows you to randomly place a selection of tiles across a large area. This is especially helpful for simple backgrounds like the one I decided to make. With most of the game done, I started working on things that I neglected to add in the first game, as well as fixing bugs and other things I may have missed. Overall, I think that this update was more than welcome. It offered many improvements to an already great game engine, too many to mention in this video. A few notable mentions would be the addition of multi-error detection, as well as more explicit error messages. I think this will provide new, and admittedly bad programmers such as myself, with an easier and faster coding experience. Another syntax change I liked was annotations, mainly when using export. This allows you to mention specifically what is being used, which makes the code not only easier to read, but more reliable as well. Yet another scripting change I liked, this is the last one I promise, is the ability to type arrays. Basically, this allows you to clearly define what type of data you want your array to hold. For example, in this case, that would be a packed scene. These are just a few changes that I think really benefit the Godot game engine. Although making the switch to Godot 4 was a bit complicated, overall, I didn't encounter many other issues other than the aforementioned scripting changes and learning curve, which is to be expected. Although, this may be due to the simplicity of my game. But remember, these are just my personal opinions. Depending on your game, you might encounter different problems. Feel free to let me know what you think of the current version of Godot. Phew, finally, the game is done. As you can see, I added a bit of game juice to make the game look a lot better, for example, vignette, and, well, that's basically it. Overall, I think I did a pretty good job. As I said, this update was marvelous, some might even say stupendous. It really changes the landscape of Godot. I'd like to hear what you think. I know I didn't cover everything in this video, if I did it would take me a long time. Anyway, thanks for watching. I hope you found this useful. I'm looking forward to making cool projects like this in the future. Remember to subscribe if you liked this video. See you later.